everyone. In this lecture of Emerging Trends in Mechanical Engineering, we will study about steam and condensate loop in process industries. In last video, we have seen the introduction to process boilers, which are used in process industries. Now, let us see the details regarding steam and condensate loop. What is this? It means how the steam is generated, distributed, controlled and used. How is the condensate recycled? A basic overview of a steam system is nothing but steam and condensate loop. Already we have seen such type of loop in power plant engineering, also in thermal engineering subject. Let us revise this in short. What are the main constituents of such type of loop? Beginning with the boiler, we know the boiler is the heart of the steam system. The typical modern packaged boiler is powered by a burner which sends heat into the boiler tubes. The boiler has a number of fittings and controls to ensure that it operates safely, economically, efficiently and at a consistent pressure. So these are the requirements. The boiler should operate safely. The boiler should be economically operated, efficiently and at a consistent pressure. So this is a component number one of the steam and condensate loop. Next is feed water. The quality of water which is supplied into the boiler is important. It must be correct temperature, usually around 80 degrees centigrade. To avoid thermal shock to the boiler and to keep it operating efficiently, it must also be the correct quality to avoid damage to the boiler. So feed water temperature should be in the range of 80 degrees centigrade, and it should be of correct quality, and so that there should not be a damage to the boiler. The water must therefore be treated with chemicals to reduce impurities in it contained. Both feed water treatment and heating takes place in the feed tank, which is usually situated high above the boiler. The feed pump will add water to the boiler when required. Heating the water in the feed tank also reduces the amount of dissolved oxygen in it. This is important as oxygenated water is corrosive. Next is blowdown. Chemical dosing of the boiler feed water will lead to the presence of suspended solids in the boiler. This will inevitably collect in the bottom of the boiler in the form of sludge and are removed by a process known as a bottom blowdown. This can be done manually. The boiler attendant will use a key to open a blowdown valve for a set period of time, usually twice a day. Next is level control. If the water level inside the boiler were not carefully controlled, the consequences could be catastrophic. If the water level drops too low and the boiler tubes are exposed, the boiler tubes could overheat and fail, causing an explosion. If water level becomes too high, water could enter the steam system and upset the process. Next is the flow of steam to the plant. When a steam condenses, its volume is dramatically reduced, which results in a localized reduction in pressure. This pressure drop through the system creates the flow of steam through the pipes. Steam quality. It is important to ensure that the steam leaving the boiler is delivered to the process in the right condition. To achieve this, the pipe work which carries the steam around the plant normally incorporates strainers, separators and steam traps. So these are the devices, strainers, separators and steam traps, which are used in increasing the steam quality. Pressure reduction. As mentioned, steam is usually generated at high pressure and the pressure may have to be reduced at the point of use, either because of the pressure limitations of the plant or temperature limitations of the process. This is achieved using a pressure reducing valve. So pressure reducing valve is there for reduction of the pressure of the steam. Steam at the point of use. A large variety of steam using plant exists. A few examples of this process industries are jacketed pan, autoclave, heater battery, process tank heating, vulcanizer, corrugator, heat exchangers. So these are some of the applications where the steam is used at the point particularly steam-using plant will require some method to control the flow of steam. A constant flow of steam at the same pressure and temperature is often not what is required. A gradually increasing flow will be needed at a start-up to gently warm the plant, and once the process reaches the desired temperature, the flow must be reduced. A variety of control types exist: pneumatically actuated valves, electrically actuated valves, and self-acting valves. Condensate removal from the plant. Often, the condensate which forms will drain easily out of the plant through the steam trap. The condensate enters the condensate drainage system. If it is contaminated, it will probably be sent to drain. If not, the valuable heat energy it contains can be retained by returning it to the boiler feed tank. This also saves the water and water treatment cost. Energy monitoring. At the last, in today's energy conscious environment, it is common for customers to monitor the energy consumption of their plant. Steam flow meters are used to monitor the consumption of the steam and used to allocate cost to individual departments or items of the plant. So this way, we have studied steam condensate loop in the process industries. So this is the reference links for more study. Thank you very much.